Based on the GSQR, the expression of intent OI worked out in 2009 laid down that the futuristic infantry combat vehicle will be operated by 3 crew members, and carry 7 additional soldiers with combat loads. It must provide protection from bullets fired by 14.5mm caliber weapons, it must be amphibious, that is capable of floating in water, it must be air transportable, which would imply a maximum weight of 18-20 tons, and it must have a grenade launcher, go axial machine gun, and be capable of firing anti-tank missiles, fire and forget type. MOD is to fund 80% of the cost of developing the FICV, the selected contractor is to pay 20%. It has been mandated that the FICV must have an indigenous content of at least 50%. The Indian Army is looking at the production of 2,600 FICVs to replace the upgraded BMPs at a cost of $10 billion. Attempt by OFB to partner DRDO as a design partner was not accepted under the plea that eventually DRDO will be the agency responsible for technology evaluation and approval and hence could not partner OFB. It appears that OFB plus 2 indigenous part companies will eventually be selected to design and build the prototypes. Earlier some sources said that Ordnance Factory Board, Larsen & Bro and a consortium of Tata Motors and Bharat Forge have been shortlisted by the ministry to make prototypes. Now the Integrated Project Management Team IPMT has been asked to seek detailed reports from all the companies, as the MOD has not been able to down-select any of the companies who have responded to OI. This entire process of getting report from all the vendors is expected to take more than a year. Even if the project were to start today, it will take several years to be finished. The first platform will only be ready in 10 years. This is a new design for everyone, said an industry player eyeing the deal. In 2015, the RFI for the FRCV was first issued by the Directorate General of Mechanized Forces DGMF. Now the Ministry of Defense has decided to procure a new generation, contemporary state-of-the-art combat vehicle platform, approximately 1770 armored fighting vehicles, in various kit combinations, in a phased manner. This vehicle, which will be called the Future Ready Combat Vehicle, FRCV, will form the base platform for the main battle tank. It is also planned to subsequently develop other need-based family of variants on this platform. The FRCV is proposed to replace the vintage D-72 tank fleet and will call for rapid dominance in an expanded battle space, characterized by real-time awareness, all-terrain agility and high mobility, precision lethal firepower, multi-layered protection and increasing use of technology. The future-ready combat vehicle will be a tracked fighting vehicle of medium weight class, all-up combat weight not to exceed 50 tons plus minus 15%, and should present a small target signature. It should be capable of all-weather, day and night operations. All systems should be able to operate in an ambient temperature range of minus 30 C to plus 50 C. The crew configuration should be 4/3, smoothbore 120mm/125mm main gun, go axial machine gun with minimum range of 1000 meters, minimum 12.7mm anti-aircraft machine gun capable of effectively engaging aerial targets up to 1,500 meters and ground targets up to 2,000 meters. Minimum 6-8 rounds per minute. 1,500 horsepower engine, not less than 25.1 horsepower/ton, with full combat weight. Maximum speed on road at least 70 km/h, cross country. At least 45 km/h, reverse at least 20 km/h. Acceleration from 0-40 km/h in not more than 10 seconds on flat gravel ground. Operating range not less than 300 km in cross-country/desert terrain and 500 km on road. The Army hopes to see the first of these enter service in the 2025-27 time frame. Russia's premier tank maker Eurowagon's Avid UVZ already had shown interest in participating in India's FRCV RFI, which will be executed under India's Strategic Partnership Policy in Defense. Impressed by Russia's T-14 armament, India started to their own future main battle tank development program. However, the dilemma facing designers of such GNMBT is whether to arrive at a configuration which is evolutionary or revolutionary in nature. An evolutionary approach per se is an extension of an existing platform with add-ons or technology upgrades so that contemporary threats are addressed. On the other hand, the alternate approach includes arriving at an altogether new configuration which not only addresses the future threats but also truly revolutionary in configuration and design. Apart from an unmanned MBT, options exist for 1, 2, 3 and 4 crew combination for generation next main battle tank. Combat weight has a huge bearing on both strategic mobility and agility, to be in the range of 45 to 50 ton class taking into account even high altitude operations. To evaluate the feasibility of both conventional and unconventional gun system for GNMBT, a comparison of various parameters is carried out as shown in table. From the comparison, it is observed that LPG, ET and M systems are superior both in terms of lethality and efficiency compared to conventional armament systems. Similarly, these systems offer lower smoke and flash in addition to ignition delay, muzzle velocity and charge temperature control. However, the weight, volume, power consumption and safety issues for the unconventional gun systems are higher compared to conventional gun system. Last month, DRDO source revealed with the upgradation of hypervelocity tunnel facility, ARD's ambitious electromagnetic gun project is on a fast track. Assembly of two rail guns of 12mm and 30mm square bore, test firing of 12mm rail gun and layout for 1.6 MJ capacitor bank has been completed, and the target is to fire 1 kg projectile with a velocity of more than 2000 meters per second with a capacitor bank of 10 MJ. If unconventional systems are adopted, then the premium internal volume in the tank will be consumed, which leads to further weight spiral and transportability issues. Hence, holistically considering all these issues, it is preferable to consider the conventional armament system for GNMBT unless miniaturization and weight reduction is attempted in the future. For the revolutionary approach, newer materials like ultra-high hardness armor steel, that is steels with hardness greater than 600 BHN than the current 300-500 BHN, shall be explored. This revolutionary design consists of a three-man crew configuration located in the frontal portion of the hull, which has maximum protection. On comparing both the configurations, it is observed that although similarities exist with respect to armament system, ammunition autoloader and transportability, they differ vastly with respect to survivability, cruising range, intelligence surveillance target acquisition and reconnaissance ISTAR, tactical mobility, trafficability and ease of adaptability. The revolutionary design as compared to the evolutionary design conforms to integrated survivability but with minimum armor. This pit-mounted configuration not only provides higher cruising range but also enough space for packaging ISTAR systems. In addition, the revolutionary design caters to superior terrain accessibility, agility and soft soil trafficability that translates it into a weapon platform capable of superior mobility in a variety of terrains. Finally, this configuration is capable of adapting itself with ease into a universal combat weapon platform for executing multi-mission requirements of the users. DRDO also had launched a project to develop an 1,800-horsepower indigenous engine, while CVRDE proposed to develop an active suspension for FMBT by 2030. With mod-issued RFI for procuring FRCV India may be pushing for revolutionary approach rather revolutionary Arjun Mk3 FMBT, as FRCV will form the base platform for the main battle tank.